guess it was 5 a.m. A homicide had been reported from one of those great big houses up on Sunset. Tomorrow, every front page is going to lead with the story. You see, an old-time movie star is involved. Maybe the biggest star. But before you read about it, before it gets distorted by those Hollywood piranhas, if you want to know the real facts, you've come to the right party. Let me take you back 6 months. I was at the bottom of the barrel. I'd had a contract back at Fox, but I'd fallen foul of Darryl. Now I'd date at Paramount, along with about 1,000 other writers. If this didn't come up roses, I'd be covering funerals back in Dayton, Ohio. So I played Hollywood roulette, along with all the other no-hopers. Have an appointment, Mr. Sheldrake.
Name?
Gillis, Joseph Gillis.
Okay.
Joseph C. Gillis?
No.
What?
I'm Joseph D. Gillis, Joseph C.'s cousin. Well, you can tell your cousin we're repossessing his car. He's way behind on his payments.
Give us the keys.
Sorry, but I'll be sure and tell cousin Joseph to shape up.
Authorized personnel only.
Hi there, Myron.
How's it hanging?
I've got a date with Sheldrake.
I'm shooting a western down at Fox.
How can you work with Darryl?
We should talk.
Gotta run, let's do lunch.
Hi, Mr. Gillis.
You look great.
I'm up for an audition.
Sheldrake is driving me insane.
Don't forget me when you're casting.
We should talk.
Gotta run, let's do lunch.
Morning, Joanna.
Hi there, Myron.
How you doing?
How's it hanging?
I've got a date with Sheldrake.
I'm up for an audition.
Try not to keep you waiting.
We should
gotta run.
Let's do lunch.
Hello, it's Sheldrake.
I am Mary.
Where have you been hiding?
I'm shooting.
Get me that bastard Nolan.
I got a date with
Sheldrake. I'm trying to make my mind up.
I'm a for
Sheldrake is never off the phone.
You undo our
boxes. Great to hear you, Nolan, sweetheart.
We should talk.
We gotta run.
And your script.
Let's do lunch.
My mind up.
It won't work.
I got a date with Sheldrake.
Who wants to see that rando kid?
I have a time I've ever seen with him. Got a big Broadway show.
Well, thought you had a deal with Darryl.
I know just how to lie.
We should talk.
We should talk. Gotta run. Let's do lunch.
Never eat lunch.
Let's do lunch.
Joe, what the fuck brings you?
You wanted to see me.
Did I? Any idea what about?
I sent you an outline.
You did. I never saw it. Nobody told me anything.
Base is loaded. It's a baseball story.
So pitch?
Well, it's about a rookie shortstop that's batting 347. The poor kid was once mixed up in a holdup, and now he's trying to go straight.
Wait a minute. I think I have read this. Can somebody out there bring me whatever we have on...
Base is loaded.
Base is loaded? They tell the kid he has to throw the World Series, am I right?
Yeah, pretty hot for it over 20th.
Good.
Listen, Mr. Sheldrake, can you let me have $300? As a personal loan? I've been grinding out original stories 2 a week for months now. Maybe they're not original enough. Maybe they're too original.
The finest things in the world have been written on an empty stomach.
Yeah, but it's not my stomach I'm worried about. It's my car.
If I lose that in this town, it's like having my legs cut off.
Here's that base's loaded material, Mr. Sheldrake. I made a 2-page synopsis of it for you, but I wouldn't bother to read it.
Why not?
It's just a rehash of something that wasn't very good to begin with.
Meet Mr. Gillis. He wrote it. This is Miss Kramer.
Schaefer. Betty Schaefer. And right now I'd like to crawl into a hole and pull it in after me.
Sounds good.
I'm sorry, Mr. Gillis. I just couldn't see the point of it. I think pictures should at least try to say a little something.
Oh, I see. You're one of the message kids. I expect you to have turned down Gone with the Wind.
No, that was me.
And I guess... I was disappointed. I've read some of the stories you wrote for the magazines, and I thought you had some real talent.
Yeah, well, that was last year. This year I felt like 80.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Gillis.
Not as sorry as I am.
Looks like Daryl's got himself a baseball picture.
Have you got anything at all? Additional dialogue? Anything?
Something may come up, I'll keep you in mind.
But I need it now.
I'm sorry, Gillis. There's nothing.
I'll come to get your knife back. It's right here, right between my shoulder blades there.
You wrote a story a couple years back about a teacher. Titled Something to Do with Windows.
Blind Windows.
I really liked it.
You're making me feel all warm and runny inside.
Maybe I can get Sheldrake to option it.
I doubt it. He likes movies with great weather and happy endings.
Why don't you let me try? Let's get together.
That's what they all say.
I'll be at Schwab's on Thursday. I'm always there around 6 o'clock.
I gotta check my diary.
We should talk.
I gotta run.
What's the rush?
See those gorillas?
Yes, what about them?
Do me a terrific favor. Show me a back way out of here.
If you agree to Thursday.
Done.
We should talk.
Gotta run, let's do lunch.
Thank you. This way. And wipe your feet.
Max, tell him to wait.
You heard. If you need my help with the coffin, call me.
Hey, wait a minute.
Any laws against burying my chimpanzee in the garden?
I wouldn't know.
I don't care anyway. No more wars to fight. White flags fly tonight. You are out of danger now. Can only come when you surrender. Hear the rockets fly, lighting up the sky. But I'll fight on to the end. Let them send their armies, I will never bend. See you now till I surrender. I'll see you again when I surrender. Now don't you give me a fancy price just because I'm rich.
Lady, you've got the wrong man. I had some trouble with my car. I just pulled into your driveway.
Get out.
Okay. And I'm sorry you lost your friend.
Get out of here.
Haven't I seen you somewhere
before? Or shall I call my servant?
Aren't you Norma Desmond? You used to be in pictures. You used to be big.
I am big. It's the pictures that got small. There was a time in this business you wouldn't remember. We had the eyes of the whole wide world. But that wasn't good enough for those Einsteins in the front office. They wanted the ears of the world as well. So they took all the idols and smashed them. The Fairbanks, the Gilberts, the Valentinos. They trampled on what was divine. They threw away the gold of silence when all they needed was this face of mine.
Don't blame me, I'm just a writer.
I put words to shame.
just one look sets the screen aflame. Silent music starts to play. One tear in my eye makes the whole world cry. With one look, they'll forgive the past. They'll rejoice I've returned at last to my people in the dark. Still out there in the dark. Silent music starts to play. With one look, you'll know all you need to know. With one look, I'll ignite a blaze. I'll return to my glory days. They'll say no mass back at last. This time I am staying. I'm staying for good. I'll be back where I was born to be. With one look, I'll be me.
Writer.
That's what it says in my driver's license.
And you've written pictures?
Sure have.
Come over here, I want to ask you something. Just what sort of length is a movie picture these days?
It depends.
I wrote this. It's a very important picture.
Looks like six very important pictures.
It's for DeMille to direct.
Oh, yeah? Will you be in it?
Of course. What do you think?
Oh, just asking. I didn't know you were planning a comeback.
I hate that word. It's a return.
Well,
I want you to read it.
You shouldn't let another writer read your stuff. He may steal it.
I'm not worried. Max, sit down.
Yes, madame.
Bring something to drink. I said sit down. It's the story of Salome, the woman. The woman who was all women. Salome, what a woman, what a part. Innocent body and a sinful heart, and flaming Herod's lust, but secretly loving a holy man. Nobody can play her like I can.
Well, I had nothing urgent coming up. I thought I might as well skim it. It's fun to see how bad, bad writing can be. This promise to go to the limit.
There's so many great scenes I can't wait. A boiling cauldron of love and hate. She ties with Herod till he's putty in her hands. He reels tormented through the desert sand.
It sure was a real cheery setup. The wind wheezing through that organ. Max shuffling around and a dead ape dumped on a shelf. And her staring like a gorgon.
They drag the Baptist up from the jail. She dances the dance of the seven bells. that says I'll give you anything.
Now it was time for some comedy relief. The guy with the baby casket must have seen a thing or two, that chimp. Shame it was too late to ask it.
Have you got to the scene where she asks for his head? If she can't have him living, she'll take him dead. They bring in his head on a silver tray. She kisses his mouth, it's a great screenplay.
It got to be 11, I was feeling ill. What the hell was I doing? Melodrama and sweet champagne and a garbled plot from a scrambled brain. But I had my own plot brewing. Just how old is Salome?
16.
I see.
Well?
It's fascinating.
Of course it is.
Could be it's a little long. Maybe the opening's wrong, but it's extremely good for a beginner.
No, it's a perfect start. I wrote that with my heart. The riverbank, the Baptist, and the sinner.
Shouldn't there be some dialogue?
I can say anything I want with my eyes.
It could use a few cuts.
I will not have it butchered.
I'm not talking limb from limb. I just mean a little trim. All you need is someone who can edit.
I want someone with a knack, not just any studio hack. And don't think for a moment I'd check credit. When were you born?
December 21st. Why?
I like Sagittarians. You can trust them.
Thanks.
I want you to do this work.
I'm a writer at my peak. I make 500 a week.
I'll pay well if I decide to take you.
I'm sure there's something here, but is it good for my career?
Don't be a fool. A chance like this could make you. Don't you worry about money, mister. I'll make it worth your while.
Well, it's getting kind of late.
Are you married, mister?
The name is Gillis. Single.
Where do you live?
Hollywood. Altonito Apartments.
You'll stay here?
I'll come back early tomorrow.
Nonsense. There's a room over the garage. Max will take you there. Max?
Yes, madame.
Take Mr. Gillis to the guest room. We'll begin at 9 sharp.
I made the bed up this afternoon.
Oh, thanks. How did you know I was going to stay?
There's soap and a toothbrush in the bathroom.
Hey. She's quite a character, isn't she? That Norma Desmond.
If you said Hollywood, as was the face you'd think of, a face on every billboard. In just a single week, she'd get 10,000 letters. Men would offer fortunes for a bloom from her corsage, or a few strands from her hair. Today, she's half forgotten, but it's the pictures that got small. She is the greatest star of all. Then you can't imagine. away fans sacrifice themselves to touch a shadow. There was a Maharaja who hanged himself with one of her discarded stockings. She's immortal, caught inside that flickering light beam is a youth which cannot fade. Madame's a living legend. I've seen so many idols fall. She is the greatest star of all.
When he'd gone, I stood looking out of the window a while. There was the ghost of a tennis court with faded markings and a sagging net. There was an empty pool where Clara Bow and Fatty Arbuckle must have swum 10,000 midnights ago. And then there was something else. The chimp's last rites, as if she were laying a child to rest. Was her life really as empty as that?
Sometime soon.
Oh, well, congratulations.
There she is, and she has some great news.
Evening, Betty.
Mr. Gillis.
What are we celebrating?
Sheldrake's the past you're looking at. Mr. DeMille's assistant.
Cecil B.
Cecil B.
That's great news.
Thanks, but that's not what we're here for. Let's talk about blind windows. Have you had time to give some thought to changing it for the movies?
Yes, I have.
Okay, shoot.
Let me think. Girl meets boy. That's a safe beginning.
Is this a western? I love those wide rolling plains.
No, it's not. They live in the city.
Then it's a thriller. The sidewalk gleams when it rains. Or how about a brilliant pianist? Every time the full moon's on the rise, he can't play without a shot of virgin's blood.
Thanks a lot. Be sure to leave your number.
You'll think of something. I'll see you opening night.
Meets boy, that's what you were saying.
She's a young teacher, he's a dirt farmer.
It sounds kinda right.
It won't sell, these days they want glamour. Fabulous heiress meets handsome Hollywood heel. Problem is, she thinks he's a dentist. Would you believe it? A wedding in the last reel.
It does. doesn't have to be so mindless. You should write from your experience. Give us something really moving, something true.
Who wants true? Who the hell wants moving? Moving means starving, and true means holes in your shoe.
No, you're wrong. They still make good pictures. Stick to your story. It's a good story.
Okay, Miss Schaefer, I give it to you.
What do you mean?
Just what I said. I've given up writing myself, so you write it.
I'm not good enough to write it on my own. I thought we could write it together.
Can't. I'm all tied up.
Couldn't we work evenings? 6 o'clock in the morning, I'll come to your place.
Betty, it can't be done. It's out. I'm sorry.
Okay. One last thing. Mr. DeMille's giving a New Year's party at Paramount, stage 18 on the set of Samson and Delilah. Will you come?
Sure. I may have given up writing, but I can always use a free meal.
But I reserve the right to badge you a little more about this project of ours.
Okay. I've always been very liberal with advice. Write this down. I'll give you some ground rules. Plenty of conflict, but nice guys don't break the law. Girl meets boy, gives herself completely. And though she loves him, she keeps one foot on the floor.
No one dies except the best friend. No one ever mentions communists. No one takes a black friend to a restaurant.
Very good. Nothing I can teach you. We could have had fun fighting the studio.
Yes, Mr. Gillis. That's just what I want.
Where have you been?
Out. I assume I can go out when I feel like it.
Madame is extremely agitated. Earlier this evening, she wanted you for something, and you could not be found.
Well, that's tough.
Don't think you understand, Mr. Gillis. Madame is extremely fragile. She has moments of melancholy.
Why? Because of her career? She's done well enough. I mean, look at all the fan mail she gets every day.
I wouldn't look too closely at the postmarks if I were you.
You mean you send them?
Would you be requiring some supper this evening, sir?
No. And Max?
Sir?
I don't know that I'm very happy about this whole arrangement. I thought it was pretty sneaky the way you brought all my stuff over from my apartment without consulting me. Now you tell me I'm supposed to be a prisoner here?
I think, sir, perhaps you had better make up your mind to abide by the rules of this house. That is, if you want this job.
I worked my way through the script. I hacked my way through the thicket. A maze of fragmented ramblings by a soul in limbo. She hovered there like a hawk, afraid I'd damage her baby.
What's that?
I thought we might cut away from the slave market.
Cut away from me?
Norma, they don't want you in every scene.
Of course they do. What else would they have come for?
The house was always so quiet. Just me and Max and the organ. No one phoned and nobody ever came. I couldn't breathe in that room. It was so full of Norma Desmond. And there was only one kind of entertainment on hand.
Joan of Arc, look at my face, isn't it strong? There in the dark, up on the screen, where I belong, we'll show them all, nothing has changed. We'll give the world new ways to dream. Everyone needs new ways to dream.
I didn't argue, why hurt her? You don't yell at her, sleepwalker, or she could fall and break her neck. She smelled of faded roses, it made me sad to watch her as she relived her glory. Poor Norma, so happy, lost in her silver heaven.
December, the rains came right through the roof of my room above the garage. So she had me move to the main house, to what Max called the room of the husbands. On a clear day, the theory was you could see Catalina. And little by little, I worked through to the end of the script, at which point I might have left. Only by then, those two boys from the finance company had traced my car and towed it away.
Well, today's the day.
What do you mean?
Max is going to deliver the script to Paramount.
You're really going to give it to DeMille?
I've just spoken with my astrologer. She read DeMille's horoscope. She read mine.
Did she read the script?
DeMille is a Leo. I'm a Scorpio. Today's the day of closest conjunction.
Well, that's all right then.
Max, see that this goes to Mr. DeMille in person.
Very good, madame.
Well.
Great day.
It's been real interesting.
Yes, hasn't it?
I want to thank you for trusting me with your baby.
Not at all. It is I who should thank you.
So will you call me and let me know when you have some news?
Call where?
My apartment.
You can't possibly think of leaving now, Joe.
The script is finished.
It's just the beginning, Joe. It's the first draft. I can't possibly think of letting you go. I need your support. You'll stay on full salary, of course.
No. It's not the money. Of course, I'll stay until we get some sort of reaction from Paramount.
Thank you, Joe.
streets, we have hounds tools.
We have dogs too.
Yes, everything to do.
And a simply marvelous coat made of vicuna.
Expensive,
but you cannot beat vicuna.
Do you think we would have forgotten? Come on, John, we've got a big surprise for you.
What size are you?
Pick out what you like, it's all been paid for.
I don't want you buying any clothes for me.
These clothes are free.
And these are not the kind of clothes I'm made for.
I am sick to death of that same old filling station shirt and that boring baggy jacket stained with yesterday's dessert.
I don't have to go to premieres, I'm never on display. Seem to forget that I'm a writer. Who cares what you wear when you're a writer?
I can't, Joanne, please don't be so mean to me.
Okay, all right.
I want you looking nice for my New Year's party.
I've been invited somewhere else on New Year's Eve.
But that's our night.
I always see the New Year in with Artie.
We have caps. We have pants. In a most unusual shape.
Fancy shapes, big and midges. We do outsize and form the wear for names. We dress G-men, we dress he-men, and seamen now and then. We guarantee a lasting impression. Yes, our clothes make a lasting impression.
This one's made in lamb's wool, it's very fine. But really, sir, if you don't mind me saying, just slip on the cashmere, it's another world.
Makes perfect gifts.
Why not have the best, the lady's paying?
Here's a brogan leather, it's very strong. But really, sir, if you don't mind me saying, our calfskin model wafts your feet to paradise.
They come with lifts.
And why not have the best, the lady's paying?
Here we have the camel hair, it's very nice. But really, sir, if you don't mind me saying, just feel the vicuna, it's a different class. And why not have the best, the lady's paying?
We have top hats, we have tails.
We supply the frills of ways of
pace. We do morning suits and evening dress for fashionable males. Single-breasted, double-breasted, and triple-breasted too. Yes, our clothes make a lasting impression.
With this chiffon scarf, I can be anyone. A Russian spy, an orphan, or a sailor. I can play the Virgin Mary, or Attila the Hun, or a flame-haired man from Venezuela. Happy New Year. Here.
Norma, I can't take this.
Oh, shut up. Open it up. Read what it says.
Mad about the boy?
Yes. And you do look absolutely divine.
Well, thank you.
I had these tiles put in, you know, because Valentino said it takes tiles to tango. Come along.
Oh, no, not on the same floor as Valentino.
Follow me. Don't lean back like that.
Yeah, it's those feathers.
Ring out the old, ring in the new, a midnight wish to share with you. Your lips are warm, my head is light, were we alive before tonight? I don't need a crowded ballroom. Everything I want is here. If you're with me, next year will be the perfect year.
Before we play some dangerous game, before we fan some harmless flame, we have to ask if this is wise and if the game is worth the prize. With this wine and with this music, how can anything be clear? Let's wait and see, it may just be the perfect year. Supposed to get here.
Who?
The other guests.
There are no other guests, just you and me. I'm in love with you. Surely you know that.
Norm, I'm the wrong kind of guy for you. You need a big shot. Someone with polo ponies, a Valentino.
What you're trying to say is you don't want me to love you. Is that it?
Max!
Sir?
Get me a taxi!
I had to get out. I needed to be with people my own age, to hear the sound of laughter and mix with hungry actors, underemployed composers, nicotine-poisoned writers, real people, real problems, having a really good time.
I knew you'd come. Oh, yeah. Wow. You're welcome.
Where'd you borrow that monkey suit from? Made off Monsieur?
Close, but no cigar.
You're at a real lucky table, Joe. I hope you know that. Every single one of us is going to make a break for next year.
My resolution is to land me a juicy part. 51's gonna be the start of a dazzling career.
I want just one thing in my stocking or in the mail. I don't care if I land in jail. I'll have fit to mature. Now I need to tell you my intentions are pure. Just an apartment with no roaches and no dry rot, where the hot water comes out hot. That's my Hollywood dream.
My resolution is to write something that gets shot with approximately the plot I first had in my head, but we get rewritten even after we're dead.
It's a year to begin a new life by a place somewhere quiet, somewhere pretty. When you have a young kid and a wife, then you need someplace green far from the city. It's a rambling old house with a big apple tree and a swing for the kid and a hammock for me.
What a great party. Here's your host, Cecil B. DeMille. I must just go and take a pill. Have a wonderful time.
Fatty will tell you every girl in the chorus line is a genuine Philistine. They don't come off the shelf. I flew everyone in from Philistia. Myself.
What's his next project?
It's called The Greatest Show on Earth. $3.6 million worth. Lots of sawdust and sex.
How's our next project?
Sheldrake's anxious to option it. I've a feeling he smells a hit. We've got so much to do.
Betty, you're forgetting that I gave it to you. You remind me of me long ago, off the bus full of ignorant ambition. Thought I'd waltz into some studio and achieve overnight recognition. But an audience thinks when it's watching a play that the actors make up every word that they say.
I've done the outline, but I can't write it on my own. Can't we speak on the telephone? All my evenings are free.
Hey, just a minute, I'm the fella who bought the ring.
Artie, this is a business thing. It's important to me. You'll be on location in Clinch, Tennessee. Please make this your New Year resolution to me.
I know I'm gonna score an amazing success.
available in the new year. In fact, I'm available right now.
Yes?
Matt, this is Mr. Gillis. Look, I want you to do me a favor.
I cannot talk now, Mr. Gillis.
Listen, I want you to get my old suitcase.
Sorry, I am attending to Madame.
What do you mean?
Madame found a razor in your room, and she cut her wrists.
What's the matter?
A silly thing was that to do.
I'll do it again. I'll do it again. I'll do it again.
Attractive headline. Great star kills herself for unknown writer.
Great stars have great pride. You must have some girl. Why don't you go to?
I never meant to hurt you, Norma. You've been good to me. You're the only person in this stinking town that's ever been good to me.
Then why don't you say thank you and go? Go. Go.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, darling.
I came out here to make my name. Wanted my pool, my dose of fame. Wanted my parking space at Warner's. But after a year, a one-room hell, a Murphy bed, a rancid smell, wallpaper peeling at the corners. Sunset Boulevard, twisting boulevard, secretive and rich, a little scary. Sunset Boulevard, tempting boulevard, waiting there to swallow the unwary. Dreams are not enough to win a war. Out here they're always keeping score. Beneath the tan, the battle rages. Smile, a rented smile, fill someone's glass. Kiss someone's wife, kiss someone's ass. We do whatever pays the wages. Sunset Boulevard, headline boulevard. Getting here is only the beginning. Sunset Boulevard, jackpot boulevard. Once you've won, you have to go on winning. I've sold out, dead right, I've sold out. I've just been waiting for the right offer. Comfortable quarters, regular rations, 24-hour, 5-star room service. And if I'm honest, I like the lady. I can't help being touched by her body. I'm treading water, taking the money, watching her sunset. Well, I'm a writer. LA's changed a lot over the years since those brave gold rush pioneers came in their creaky covered wagons. Far as they could go, end of the line. Their dreams were yours, their dreams were mine. But in those dreams were hidden dragons. Sunset Boulevard, frenzied boulevard, swamped with every kind of false emotion. Sunset Boulevard, brutal boulevard, just like you will wind up in the ocean. Was sinking fast, I threw a rope. Now I have suits and she is hope. It seemed an elegant solution. One day this must end, it isn't real. Still I'll enjoy a hearty meal before tomorrow's execution. Sunset Boulevard, ruthless boulevard, destination for the stony hearted. Sunset Boulevard, lethal boulevard, everyone's forgotten how they started here on Sunset Boulevard.
There's been a call. What did I say? They want to see me right away. Joe Paramount, they love the script. Mr. DeMille has really flipped.
Wonderful.
But it was some fool assistant. Not acceptable at all. If he wants me, then Cecil B. himself must call.
I don't think this is the time to stand on ceremony.
I've been waiting 20 years now. What's a few more days, my dear? It's happened, Joe. I told you so. The perfect year. Now let's go upstairs.
Shouldn't you at least call back?
No. They can wait until I'm good and ready.
It took her 3 days and she was ready. She checked with her astrologer, who sacrificed a chicken. She dressed up like a pharaoh, slapped on a pound of makeup, and set forth in her chariot. Poor Norma, so happy, re-entering her kingdom.
If you'll pardon me, madame, the shadow of the left eye is not quite balanced.
Thank you, ma'am.
That's enough of that!
to see Mr. DeMille. Open the gate.
Mr. DeMille is shooting. You need an appointment.
This is Norma Desmond. No appointment is necessary.
Norma who?
Jonesy!
Wife, isn't Miss Desmond?
Open the gate, Jonesy!
You heard Miss Desmond.
I don't have a pass.
Stage 18, Miss Desmond.
Thank you, Jonesy. And teach your friends some manners. Tell them without me there wouldn't be a Paramount studio.
Norma Desmond to see Mr. DeMille.
Won't you come in, darling?
No, it's your script. It's your show. Good luck.
Thank you, darling. This way, Miss Desmond.
Well, well, well.
Mr. DeMille. Last time I saw you was someplace terribly gay. I was dancing on a table.
A lot of people were. Lindbergh had just landed.
You read the script, of course.
Why? Well, yes.
I know how busy you are when you're shooting, but I do think you could have picked up the phone yourself instead of leaving it to some assistant.
What do you mean, Norma?
You know what I mean.
Why don't you make yourself comfortable, my dear? I'm just setting up a shot.
Desmond! Hey, Miss Desmond! Up here, Miss Desmond! It's Hawkeye!
Hawkeye! Well, hello!
Let's get a look at you.
Cameras will start turning.
conversations in overcrowded hallways. So much to say, not just today, but always. We'll have early morning manners. We'll have magic in the making. Yes, everything's as if we never said goodbye.
Sick friend, let's get together sometime soon. I'll call you at the office. It's just not a good time, not right now.
You're Miss Desmond's German Shepherd. I'm the one who's been calling. We want to rent this car of hers right for the Crosby picture.
This is outrageous. You insult her. Tell Bing to find his own car. Don't you dare say one word to her, or you'll be back on welfare. It's just not a good time, not right now.
Don't forget it's in my contract. I won't work before 10:30. Soon you'll finish this little picture of yours. The old team will be back in business.
Your script has a few good things. It's expensive, New York must be consulted. Let's have a good long talk one day. Sorry, my next shot's ready.
I can't write
this. This is outrageous.
Don't forget.
New Year crisis.
It's expensive.
I thought you said you'd help me.
Helping to find his own
car. I won't work before 10:30.
Let's get together sometime soon.
Let's have a real good talk one day.
The old team will be back. All the smiling children. Ryan's hot.
It's just not a good time.
Start right now.
What's the matter, Max?
I've just found out the reason for all those calls from Paramount.
Yes?
It's not Madame they want. It's her car.
Oh, my God.
Goodbye, young fellow. We'll see what we can do.
I'm not worried. It's so wonderful to be back.
Was that really Norma Desmond?
It was.
Oh, she must be about a million years old.
I hate to think where that puts me. I could be a father.
I'm sorry, Mr. DeMille.
could have seen her at 17, when all of her dreams were new. Beautiful and strong, before it all went wrong, she's never known the meaning of surrender.
How about they don't know each other? He works the night shift and she takes classes all day. Here's the thing, they both share the same room, sleep in the same bed, it works out cheaper that way.
Well, I've a feeling you're just kidding, but to me it sounds believable. Makes a better opening than that car chase scene. Girl finds boy borrowing her toothbrush, or oversleeping, or at her sewing machine.
Some real possibilities here.
Who's Norma?
Who's who?
I'm sorry. I don't usually read private cigarette cases.
Oh, but Norma's a friend of mine, a middle-aged lady. Very foolish, very generous.
I'll say. This is solid gold. Mad about the boy?
So how's Artie?
Stuck in Tennessee. It rains all the time. They're weeks behind. Nobody knows when they'll get back.
Good.
What's good about it? I'm missing him something fierce.
No. I mean, I think this idea we had is really pretty good. Back to work. What if he's a teacher?
Where does that get us? Don't see what good it would do.
No, it's great if they have the same job. So much in common, they fall in love, wouldn't you?
Yes, but if he's just a teacher, we lose those scenes in the factory.
Not if he's a champion for the working man. Girl likes boy, she respects his talent.
Working with someone can turn you into a fan.
This is fun, writing with a partner.
Yes, and it could be
hell of a movie.
Can we really do this?
I know.
A perilous time for Pisces. If you wait till Venus is in the Capricorn, you'll avoid a catalog of crises.
I need 2 more weeks to get these thighs in shape. No more carbohydrates, don't be naughty. Good, now go. We'll soon have you skipping like an ingenue. Look a day over 40.
We have dry heat, we have steam, we have moisturizing cream, we have mud packs, we have blood sets.
It's a rigorous regime.
Not a wrinkle when you twinkle,
but a bubble when you bone.
Of course there's bound to be a little suffering.
Eternal youth is worth a little suffering. Of course there's to be a little suffering. Eternal youth is worth a little suffering.
Is this what you're looking for by any chance?
Why, yes.
Whose number is this? I was worried about the line of my throat, but this woman has done wonders with it.
Good.
And I've lost a half a pound since Tuesday.
Very good.
And now it's after nine. I'd better go to bed.
You had.
Are you coming up?
I think I'll read a little longer.
You went out last night, didn't you, Joe?
I went out for a walk.
You took the car.
I drove to the beach.
Who's Betty Schaefer?
Surely you don't want me to feel I'm a prisoner in this house.
It's just that I don't want to be left alone, Joe, not while I'm under this terrible strain. All I ask is a little kindness, a little patience.
Norma, I haven't done anything.
Of course you haven't, darling. Good night, darling.
I should have stayed there, poor Norma, so desperate to be ready for what would never happen, what Betty would be waiting. We had the script to finish, one unexpected love scene. Poor Norma, so happy, re-entering the kingdom.
The end! I can't believe it, I finished my first script!
Stop it! You're making me feel old.
It's exciting though, isn't it?
How old are you anyway?
22.
Smart girl.
Shouldn't we open some champagne?
Well, the best I can offer is a stroll to the water cooler at the end of the lot.
Sounds good to me. I was born two blocks from here. My father was head electrician at the studio until he died, and mother still works in wardrobe.
Second generation, huh?
Third. Grandma did stunt work for Pearl White.
Yeah. I guess it is kind of exciting. At that, finishing a script.
What?
You all right?
Sure.
Something's the matter, isn't it?
I got a telegram from Artie.
Is there something wrong?
He wants me to come out to Tennessee. He says it would only cost $2 to get married in Clinch.
Oh, what's stopping you? Now that the script is finished. Hey, what are you crying about? You're getting married, isn't that what you wanted?
Not anymore.
Why not? What happened? Don't you love Artie?
Of course I do. I'm just not in love with him anymore, that's all.
Well, then what happened?
You did. When I was a kid, I played in this street. I always loved illusion. I thought make-believe was truer than life, but now it's all confusion. Please, can you tell me what's happening? I just don't know anymore. If this is real, how should I feel? What should I look for?
If you were smart, you would keep on walking out of my life as fast as you can. I'm not the one you should pin your hopes on. You're falling for the wrong kind of man. This is crazy. You know we should call it a day. Sound advice, great advice. Let's throw it away.
I can't control all the things I'm feeling. I haven't got a prayer. If I'm a fool, well, I'm too much in love to care. I knew where I was. I'd given up hope, made friends with disillusion. No one in my life. Now I look at you, and now it's all confusion.
Please, can you tell me what's happening? I just don't know anymore. If this is real, how should I feel? What should I look for? I thought I had everything I needed. My life was set, my dreams were in place. My heart could see way into the future. All of that goes when I see your face. I should hate you. There I was, the world in my hand. Can one kiss away everything I planned? I can't control all the things I'm feeling. I'm floating in midair. I know it's wrong, but I'm too much in love to care.
I thought I had everything I needed. My life was set, my dreams were in place. My heart could see
the car.
Please be very careful as you cross the patio. Madame may be watching.
Oh! Well, suppose I tiptoe up the back stairs and undress in the dark. Will that do it?
It's just that I'm greatly concerned about Madame.
But we're not helping her any. Feeding her lies and more lies. What happens when she finds out they're not going to make her picture?
She never will. That is my job. I made her a star. I will never let her be destroyed.
You made her a star?
I directed all her early pictures. In those days, there were three young directors who showed promise. D.W. Griffith, Erich von Stroheim,
and... You must be Max Mierling.
That's right. When we met, she was a child, barely 16. Awkward, and yet she had an air I'd never seen. I knew I'd found my perfect face deep
in her eyes, new ways to dream, and we inspired new ways to dream. Talkies came, I stayed with her, took up this life, threw away fame. Please understand, she was my wife. We had achieved far more than most. We gave the world new ways to dream. Everyone needs new ways to dream.
You're telling me you were married to her?
I was the first husband.
Hello, is this Gladstone room 9281? Miss Schaefer? Miss Schaefer, please forgive me for calling so late, but I really feel it's my duty. It's about Mr. Gillis. You do know a Mr. Gillis? Well, exactly how much do you know about him? Do you know where he lives? Do you know what he lives on?
I want to spare you a lot of sadness. I don't know what he's told you, but I can guarantee you he doesn't live with Mother. Or what you call a roommate. He's just a... I can't say it. Poor Betty. You ask him. I'd like to hear his answer.
That's right, Betty. Why don't you ask me? Or better yet, come over and see for yourself. Yes! Right now. The address is 10,086 Sunset Boulevard.
Don't hate me, Joe. I did it because I need you. Look at me. Look at my hands. Look at my face. Look under my eyes. How can I go back to work if I'm wasting away? Please don't hate me, Joe. Shout at me, strike me, but say you don't hate me. Please say you don't hate me.
The star, the hospitality is stellar.
So this is where you're living?
Yes, it's quite a place. Sleep 17, 8 sunken tubs, a movie screen, a bowling alley in the cellar.
I didn't come to see a house, Joe.
Sunset Boulevard, cruise the boulevard. Win yourself a Hollywood palazzo. Sunset Boulevard, mythic boulevard. Boulevard. Valentino danced on the terrazzo.
Who's it belong to?
Just look around you.
That's Norma Desmond.
Right on the money. That's Norma Desmond. That's Norma Desmond. That's Norma Desmond. That's Norma Desmond.
Why did she call me?
Give you three guesses. It's the oldest story in the book. Come see the take of being took. The world is full of Joes and Normas. Older woman, very well to do. Meets younger man, a standard cue for two mechanical performers.
Pack your things and let's get out of here.
You need all my things, have you gone mad? Leave all my things I've never had. Leave this luxurious existence. You want me to face that one room hell, that Murphy bed, that rancid smell. Go back to living on subsistence. There's no time to begin a new life. Now I finally made a perfect landing. I'm afraid there's no room for a wife, not unless she's uniquely understanding. You should go back to Artie and marry the fool, and you'll always be welcome to swim in my pool.
I can't look at you anymore, Joe. You're not leaving me.
Yes, I am.
You can't. Max! Max!
It's been a bundle of laughs. And thanks for the use of the trinkets.
A little ritzy for the copy desk back in Dayton.
And there's something you should know.
I want to do you this favor. They'll never shoot that hopeless script of yours.
They only wanted your code.
That's a lie. They still want me. What about all my fan mail?
It's Max who writes your letters. Your audience has vanished. They left when you weren't looking.
Nothing's wrong with being 50 unless you're acting 20.
I am the greatest star of them all.
Goodbye, Norma.
No one ever leaves a star.
Happy New Year, darling. If you're with me, next year will be the perfect year. They bring in his head on a silver tray. She kisses his mouth. It's a great screenplay. They'll say Norma's back at last. We taught the world new ways to dream. Has there ever been a moment with so much to live for? Max, where am I?
This is the staircase of the palace. And they're waiting for your dance.
Of course, now I remember. I was so frightened I might fall.
Lights, cameras, action!
So happy. May I say a few words, Mr. DeMille? I can't tell you how wonderful it is to be back in the studio making a picture. I promise you, I will never desert you again. And now I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille. This is my life. It always will be. There is nothing else. Just us. The cameras. And all you wonderful people out there in the dark.